Okay, so here we have to solve this radical equation. Square root of negative 2x minus 5 minus 4 is equal to x, right? The negative 4 is outside the radical sign. And the way we're going to solve this is by isolating the radical, and then we can square both sides of the equation to get rid of that radical, right? Square and square root are opposite operations, inverse operations, and so they cancel each other out, and then we'll just have a linear or quadratic equation, and we can solve from there. So how we're going to do this is just, again, isolate the radical. So add 4 to both sides, so we get rid of that negative 4 on the left side of the equation. There we go. We have x plus 4 on the right, and now we can square both sides of the equation. And on the left, you can see the square root is just going to cancel out, right? Because square and square root are opposites. And on the right, we have x plus 4 times x plus 4. If you FOIL that out, you're going to get x squared plus 8x plus 16. And now you can see we have just a quadratic equation. So how we're going to solve this is move all the terms to the same side, and then maybe factor, we'll see if we can factor it. If not, we'll use the quadratic formula. So add 2x to both sides and add 5 to both sides. And so we're going to get 10x on the right, right? 8 plus 2. And we're going to get 16 plus 5, that's 21 on the right. And so we have 0 is equal to x squared plus 10x plus 21. And if you take a look at this trinomial, you can indeed factor it into x plus 7 times x plus 3. And right, solve from here. Each of these terms can be set equal to 0. And we solve for x. And so x is equal to negative 7 and negative 3. But we have to check these answers, right? Because whenever you square both sides of an equation, you could introduce what's called extraneous solutions, or solutions that are not actual. You might find solutions at the end that are not actual solutions of the original equation. So here we go. Got to plug those in back to the original equation. So here on the left, let's see if I can do this. Or maybe I'll just get rid of this paper, right? So negative 7, plug in x equals negative 7 here, and we're going to get negative 2 times negative 7 minus 5. So what's this? Well, negative 2 times negative 7, that's 14, minus 5 is 9, square root of 9 is 3, 3 minus 4 is negative 1, and you can see that's not equal to x, which is negative 7 on the right side, and so negative 7 is actually not a solution to this equation. How, if we take a look at the other one, plug in x equals negative 3, and here we have negative 2 times negative 3, that's positive 6. Minus 5 is 1. Square root of 1, obviously, is 1. So 1 minus 4 is negative 3. And that is indeed equal to x, which again is negative 3. And so negative 3 is indeed a solution. So our only actual solution to this equation is x equals negative 3.